Well, I think that people realize this is an honor killing. That actually, the concept or the notion of honor that powerful people have, and then that's why she had to be eliminated. And also, let me say that powerful people in our society seem to have honor. The powerless don't. So the powerful tend to wonder why somebody else is raising the voice. So I think that's what's happened. The other thing is that if we just say that this is powerful, the voice is an outspoken person, then we should shiver. Remember Perumal Murugan, the one who declared himself dead because he wasn't now allowed to speak and stay alive, alive as in breathing. So he declared himself dead. This is the country we become. But it's extraordinary that everybody in the country should have woken up to this. But I really do think that these are very times that alarm us. This is where we start. And the other thing I'd like to also say while we are talking about this is that we have only one person wins an argument here. And I would caution TV anchors, television anchors, to stop these raucous debates and to have back to what we are, which is a strong, stable, and tolerant people at our core. But I think that people have lost sight of what democracies really are. Democracy is a melting pot. All kinds of views, all kinds of approaches, and you have to hear everybody. You cannot shout it down. But what's extraordinary is that persons are now silenced. Earlier they were silenced in Perumal Murugan, who just declared himself dead. Now they are silenced because people are actually killed. What I criticize is if the media just now does not wake up and know that this is how it starts. This is how it starts. And maybe next year, when I will be able to also do this interview.